Salvation po is not by assumption but by revelation. A lot of people kasi assume certain things when it comes to their relationship with God. Unfortunately, yung assumptions na ganoon are often wrong, no? And when our assumptions are wrong, our conclusions and inevitably yung applications natin will also be wrong, no? And this is the reason why so many people remain lost, kasi they have false assumptions, yung akala nila, no? And in particular, yung understanding ng mga tao of how a person really becomes part of God's people can often be based on wrong assumptions. In fact, a lot of people think now, well, because they are human beings, they are part of God's family, o kaya because maybe a family member goes to church, then kasama na sila doon. So there's a lot of misunderstanding, kaya hindi tuloy, you know, na re-realize ng mga tao that they need to make a personal choice to believe in the gospel. Now, the Apostle Paul, dun sa Book of Romans, especially so far dun sa mga na-cover na nating mga chapters, mula chapter 1 hanggang 8, we are now in chapter 9. So in the previous chapters, talagang he has been explaining na lahat ng tao, whether Jew or Gentile, ay kinakailangan maligtas. And only through the gospel of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Walang pwedeng ipagmalaki o panghawakan, no, that can make a person righteous before God. It's only by trusting in Jesus as the Messiah, as the Lord of all, as the Savior, can a person be put right with God. Now, sa kanyang pag-explain ng katotohanan na yun, of course, it may come to, you know, to the point na some people, especially mga Jews, might feel na parang, ano sila, parang di na sila kasali, no? And of course, one of the things that Paul shares at napag-usapan na natin to, ay yung kanyang matinding kalungkutan dahil hindi lahat, o you know, konti lang, in other words, sa mga Hudyo ang tumatanggap sa mabuting balita. Of course, si Paul is an example of those who have believed in the gospel, and there are others, of course. Pero majority, hindi ano, tumatanggap sa mabuting balita. And at the same time, of course, siyempre, because of their rejection of the gospel, ang ibig sabihin nun, they are cut off, you know, from Christ. And they are not able to experience yung the potential of their ika nga heritage, kung tutuusin, dahil sila ay people of God, no? Pero having said that, no, siyempre parang magko-question ngayon yung mga Hudyo na, so ibig sabihin ba wala nang visa yung mga pangako ng Panginoon? And so that brings the bigger picture of yung sino ba ang maaring maging bahagi talaga ng people of God, you know? So parang Paul needs to backtrack and explain kung ano ba yung ano way for a person to be really included in the family of God. And so he wants to clarify yung mga false assumptions. So let's read itong verses 6 to 13. Admittedly, of course, this is one of the toughest passages in the book of Romans, you know, and even in the entire Bible, kung tutusin. Kasi it talks about matters na siyempre maraming questions tayo rito. But let's keep in mind Paul's intention. You know? He's trying to answer yung basically yung question ng mga Hudyo dahil parang feeling nila hindi na sila kasali. You know? And so parang lumalabas ngayon, they're arguing. So paano na yung mga pangako ng Panginoon sa Israel? And so he's going to explain, you know, how that works out. Kasi there is no way that he can compromise on the truth of the gospel, no? And at the same time, of course, hindi rin naman niya pwedeng isang tabi lang, lalong-lalo na yung mga pangako ng Panginoon sa Israel. So he needs to explain that. So that's why itong verses 6 to 13 is the initial ano, parang attempt of Paul to explain. So basahin po natin to, and then we'll pray. Verse 6, it is not as though God's word had failed, For not all who are descended from Israel are Israel, nor because they are his descendants are they all Abraham's children. On the contrary, it is through Isaac that your offspring will be reckoned. Verse 8, in other words, it is not the natural children who are God's children, but it is the children of the promise who are regarded as Abraham's offspring. Verse 9, for this is how the promise was stated. At the appointed time, I will return, and Sarah will have a son. Now, verse 10 says, not only that, but Rebekah's children had one and the same father, our father Isaac. Verse 11, yet before the twins were born or had done anything good or bad, in order that God's purpose in election might stand. Verse 12, not by works, but by him who calls, she was told the older will serve the younger. And then finally in verse 13, just as it is written, Jacob I loved, but Esau I hated. Ayan, purihin ang Panginoon. Tayo po ay manalangin and ask God to guide us right now dito sa ating pag-uusapan. Heavenly Father, maraming salamat po for your grace and mercy, Lord, na you have once again gathered us online. Thank you po sa lahat ngayon na nakikinig, whether those that are identifiable kasi nagko-comment sila, and even those na hindi ko alam, but they are out there listening right now. Lord, as you bring us together in your presence this morning, mangusap po kayo. Help us to hear your word and help us to receive it. And by the grace of God, help us to see how important and how applicable itong mga bagay na ito sa amin din na mga mananampalataya, as well as those na nais mo na madala sa iyong kaharian. So I pray, Lord, for wisdom. I pray na you would help us and that you would also guide me in what I would say. I pray na as I open my mouth, words may be given me so that I may speak the truth, Lord, and not add or subtract anything na nais mo na masabi right now. So, Lord, entrust to you itong devotional namin ngayon, and may you truly bless us with your presence, O God. Ito ang prayer po namin sa pangalan ni Jesus. Amen and amen. All right. So, purihin ang Panginoon. Being part of God's people, yan po ang topic natin today. And of course, you know, one of the things na minsan nagiging misunderstanding, no, sa mga tao is, especially when they hear Christians talk, you know, parang nagiging argumento nila, bakit kayo lang ba ang anak ng Diyos, o kayo lang ba ang ligtas, you know, something to that effect, you know. And of course, during the time of Paul, ang pinaka-significant na argument ay galing doon sa mga Israelites, no? Yung mga Hudyo. Kasi of all people, sila yung parang naniniwala na they are the chosen people of God. You know? And of course, siyempre, ang nagiging problem doon is that the way Paul explains the gospel, lumalabas ngayon na sila ay hindi kasali doon, no? And so, ang question that would come up to their minds would be, well, paano na nangyari yun? Paano na yung mga pangako ni Lord, you know, sa Old Testament concerning the people of God? Ibig sabihin ba, no, na baliwala na yan? So, this has to do with some assumptions or misunderstandings concerning what it means to be part of the people of God, no? So, whether sa konteksto natin, tayong mga modernong tao, wherein sometimes we feel na parang, you know, well, parang may judgment na, okay, porque hindi ako born again Christian, parang kayo lang ang anak ng Diyos. Yung ganung klaseng argument. Or maybe, you know, especially among the Jews, you know, since talagang of all people, pwede nila i-claim yun. So how do we navigate yung issue na yan? So, the question that we want to look at is, how does one become part of God's people, no? Ano ba yung katotohanan tungkol dito? And that's what Paul is trying to explain. So he's basically talking about two revelations. At least this is the start nitong pag-a-argue na ito. In fact, it goes hanggang katapusan ng chapter 11. So we're not going to be done with this, agad-agad. We will have to cover some more material before we can understand all of it. Pero itong umpisa na ito, Paul shares two revelations about how one becomes part of God's people, no? First of all, no, he explains na it is not by parentage, no, or maybe heritage, but by God's promise. Hindi ito parang by blood, no, or sa pamamagitan ng pamilya, no, but rather it is based on God's promise. And Paul talks about that in verses 6 to 9. So tingnan natin yung para maunawaan natin. Not by parentage, but by God's promise. This is how we belong to God's people. Ito ang sabi niya, no? Verse 6. It is not as though God's word had failed. Kasi nga, ang argumento ng mga supposedly parang imaginary opponent ni Paul, you know, is paano na? Ano nangyari sa mga pangako ng Panginoon kung kami hindi nakasali? I mean, if the Israelites are no longer part of God's people, so ano na nangyari sa mga pangako ni Lord, no? And Paul, of course, was talking about that previously in verse 5 na, you know, na may mga privileges ang Israel. So the question would be, well, so paano na nangyari doon? Because so we are not part, as you say, Paul, we're not part of God's people anymore because we reject the gospel. So how do you deal with the promises of God? So ganito ang sagot ni Paul. It is not as though God's word had failed. So there's no problem on the side of God. In other words, yung promises ni God remains and his calling, you know, for Israel remains. That has not changed. Hindi nagbabago yung kanyang mga pangako. Sabi niya, pero sabi, kinlarify niya, but for not all who are descended from Israel are Israel. Now, this is something na, you know, parang revelation ito sa mga Hudyo at that time. Na hindi porket, you know, as far as your parents are concerned, ikaw ay Israelite, or sabihin natin as far as the fact na you belong to that race, eh, automatically, you are now part of God's people. Sabi ni Paul, for not all who are descended from Israel are Israel. So, hindi lahat ng tao na pinanganak na Israelite ay automatically, they belong to this category of Israel or the people of God. Again, sabi niya sa verse 7, nor because they are his descendants are they all Abraham's children. Now, of course, for the typical na Israelite or Jew, usually, Jew is how people call, you know, the Jews. Pero Israelite is how they call themselves. Yan ang tawag nila, sarili nila, Israelites. So, not because they are descendants are they all Abraham's children. So, ang pinaka-main contention or conviction ng isang Israelite is that he or she comes from the line of Abraham, no? And Paul is saying, basically, na hindi porket totoo yun, ethnically speaking, it follows na they are Abraham's children. On the contrary, sabi niya, and this is how he explains it, it is through Isaac that your offspring will be reckoned. Now, what does he mean by that? No, it is through Isaac that your offspring will be reckoned. In other words, yung mga ituturing na descendants ni Abraham ay hindi lang yung mga lalabas sa kanya at kay Sarah, you know, I mean, in terms of yung kanilang physical lineage. If you remember, no, sa book of Genesis, bago dumating si Isaac, ay lumabas muna si Ishmael, no? Na, of course, it is through Hagar, yung servant ni Sarah, na pinanganak si Ishmael. So, si Ishmael actually nauna kaysa kay Isaac. So, in terms of physical lineage, si Ishmael is also you know, a descendant of Abraham, also a child of Abraham. Pero sabi ni Paul, it is only through Isaac, or it is through Isaac that your offspring will be reckoned. And then in verse 8, sabi niya, in other words, it is not the natural children who are God's children, but it is the children of the promise who are regarded as Abraham's offspring. In other words, it was through the miracle that happened, you know, through, siyempre si Sarah was barren, and then si Abraham also was already old, ganun din naman si Sarah. So it was a miraculous event, no, that Isaac was actually born, no? But that's exactly God's promise, no? Kaya sabi niya sa verse 9, for this was how the promise was stated, at the appointed time, I will return, and Sarah will have a son. So the Jews, or the Israelites rather, who are listening to this argumentation, you know, would recall this particular story. Now, it was through a promise that God made to Abraham and Sarah that they will have a son, yun na nga si Isaac. And sabi ni Lord sa kanila, it would be through Isaac that the people of God will come from, you know, through a promise. So this brings us to a very important point, no, na sinasabi ni Paul. Now, being part of God's people is hindi sa pamamagitan ng parentage, kundi by God's promise. Now, how do we apply that, you know, sa sarili natin? We're not Jews, of course, we're not Israelites. Pero first, let's imagine yung tinutukoy niya sa isa among the Israelites. Kasi sila, they're very particular about yung ethnicity nila. In fact, yun ang dahilan why if you read the book of Matthew, sa chapter 1, there's this long list of names, no? Tracing back kung saan ang galing si Jesus. Ganun din sa Gospel of Luke, no? Wala ito sa Mark and sa John. Pero these two Gospels, Matthew and Luke, no? Is of course addressing, lalo na si Matthew, he's addressing Jewish concerns. So he had to prove that Jesus had a clear lineage, no, going back, no, to Abraham. So in other words, very particular ang mga Jews tungkol dito sa kanilang yung pagiging descendant nila. Even today, you know. If you claim to be an Israelite, chine-check nila yung DNA mo, you know, just to make sure that you are indeed from that physical lineage. So in other words, very proud sila na they are descendants of Abraham. But here's Paul arguing na, you know, being part of the people of God is not something na automatic just because yung parents mo ay mga Hudyo. No, or even the fact na ikaw by ethnicity ay isang Hudyo. Because he's saying in effect na not all Israel is Israel. Now, if we apply it ngayon sa ating mga sarili, since hindi naman tayo mga Hudyo, what can we say? Well, I believe it's also true na tayo rin po, even today, minsan merong misunderstanding. Lalo na, for example, sa Pilipinas, just to give an illustration, we call the Philippines, of course, the only Christian nation in Southeast Asia, or predominantly Christian nation. Dahil kasi, kumbaga, yung mga magulang natin ay Christian, hindi naman sila Muslim, for example, or Buddhist, or whatever, no? They're Christians. And we assume na pag tayo ay, pinanganak sa ganung klaseng pamilya, then ergo by implication, we're also Christian. Now, this is also true kahit na sa mga born-again Christians, no? There are some who grow up in the church, some who basically never had any experience dun sa previous faith, katulad ng mga magulang nila. Like, for example, I was a Roman Catholic before. So, yung mga anak ko have never really experienced, you know, what it means to be a Roman Catholic. Kasi ako, I converted to being a born-again Christian when I was 22 years old. Now, my children, wala silang ganung karanasan, no? They were born in a Christian family, and they grew up in church. So, here's where the problem is, you know? Kasi minsan, dahil hindi ito na ipapaliwanag ng maayos o hindi naiintindihan, sometimes people assume na porkit pinanganak sila in a Christian family, o kaya nakagisna na nila ay Christian church, halimbawa, they assume that they are already Christians. And this is, of course, one of the problems, lalong-lalo na, to sa mga kabataan na hindi naman sila pinanganak na ano, kumbaga, they were not born in an unbelieving family. They grew up with the Bible and preaching and so forth and so on. Pero they've never really made a decision to trust in Jesus Christ. Kaya maraming mga quote-unquote Christian teenagers who lose their faith. Because they never really had faith to begin with. Basically, na-pass on lang sa kanila. You know, yung pananampalataya. But they never really understood it. So what does it mean? Well, of course, siyempre, unang-una sa lahat, we have to understand na hindi by proxy ang, you know, being part of the people of God. It is by faith, of course. You know, as Paul has already explained, it is by trusting in Jesus as your Lord and Savior. So, unang implication yan is dapat if you are a person who grew up in church, is dapat talaga alamin mo yung gospel and you yourself must make a decision. But another implication dito bilang mga magulang, let's not assume na porket yung mga anak natin ay lumaki sa Christian church na it follows that they are already Christian kasi doon na nga sila lumaki, yun ay nakagisna nila. Kaya one of the saddest things of course is that we never really take the time to sit down with our children and ask them, so what do you understand about the gospel? Lalo na ako bilang pastor, siyempre, dahil yung mga anak ko lumaki na sa church. So I really need to every now and then talk to them and clarify kung ano ibig sabihin ng gospel, no? And what does it mean to believe? And to be honest, it's not easy kasi yun nga, lumaki na nga sila sa Christian church. Eh. Now what about you? Maybe may mga anak kayo na sinasabi nyo nga na tumanggap na siya eh, ganito eh, or umaten siya ng church, di ba? But they are not showing by their lives yung devotion or yung discipleship nila in the Lord. Then, instead of course being frustrated about it, why don't you sit down with them and talk to them about the good news, about yung understanding nila sa gospel? And it may take a while, and maybe hindi sa isang upuan lang yan. And I do believe na ang pagpe-present ng gospel ay hindi minamadali. It must be clearly explained, you know. And what I see in a lot of cases is minsan yung mga magulang do not take the time or make the time. Kasi ina-assume nila eh, na yung mga anak nila tumanggap daw kay Lord nung bata pa o sa Sunday school o tumanggap kay Jesus nung ganitong youth camp. Those things are, you know, meaningless, you know. What is important is, have they really trusted in Jesus as their Lord and Savior? Kasi a person does not become part of God's family just because yung family nila ay Christian. They must make a decision on their own. Now, secondly, what Paul explains or clarifies dito is that it's not by privilege, but by God's purpose. In a way, that's related to what he already said. No? Kasi yung mga Hudyo may privilege sila. But he goes further than that in verses 10 to 13. So tingnan natin yun, verse 10 to 13. Sabi niya sa verse 10, not only that, but Rebekah's children had one and the same father, our father Isaac. Now, medyo nag-jump na ngayon si Paul sa kanyang argumentation, hindi na, you know, between Ishmael and Isaac. He now moves forward ngayon kay Rebecca naman, no? Si Rebecca, of course, had twins, you know? Si Esau and also si Jacob. Si Jacob eventually ay tinawag na Israel. Si Esau naman eventually naging nation yan, Edom, no? So, dalawang nation ang twins ang pinanganak kay Rebecca, you know, one nation became Israel and another nation became Edom. So anyway, pero isa lang ang father nila, si Isaac. So sabi nga nito, yet before the twins were born or had done anything good or bad. So in other words, wala pa silang ginagawa, no? In order that God's purpose in election might stand. So here what Paul is, you know, mentioning dito yung election. It's often debated upon and misunderstood, okay? And often to the point na parang, you know, lumalabas na God is really the one who chooses, you know, ang basically masasave, that hindi masasave. So, hindi ka pinili ni Lord na hindi ka masasave. Kawawa ka naman. Only those na pinili ni Lord na masasave, sila lang yung masasave. All of that misunderstanding is really due to the fact na nami-miss out natin what Paul is really trying to say. He's trying to clarify kasi why is it na yung mga, some of the, or marami sa mga Israelites do not believe in the gospel. And so, you know, paano na sila? And Paul is trying to clarify or explain na hindi ang ano ang pagiging part ng people of God ay hindi automatic dahil kasi you are a descendant of Abraham. And sinasabi niya ngayon dito na it is actually based on God's election, you know. So sabi niya, not by works but by him who calls. Now, he does not yet explain how God calls. Later on, of course, he will clarify that sa chapter 10. Pero even in the previous verses, you know, he already clarified na it is through the gospel that God calls people. Okay? And then sabi niya, she was told the older will serve the younger. In other words, it is God who establishes yung way that a person becomes part of, you know, the people of God. Hindi dahil meron silang privilege. Kasi in those days, kapag panganay ka, mas ikaw yung ano, ikaw yung may privilege, no? Pero dito sabi niya, the older will serve the younger. So in other words, si Esau, si Edom, no, will have a, ano, ang kanya magiging role is to submit to Jacob or Israel. Now, how that worked out, of course, malalaman natin yan pag binasa natin yung story sa Genesis. Because it is not as if parang, you know, parang automatic lang yun. People had choices to make. Now, Paul jumps to the book of Malachi. Sabi niya, just as it is written, Jacob I love, but Esau I hated. Now, yung word na hate, of course, doesn't mean na parang galit si Lord kay Esau. Kundi this has to do with acceptance and rejection. No? In other words, pinili ni Lord, you know, that Jacob or Israel will become his people. At hindi si Esau, no? Even though si Esau was older, no? Si Jacob was chosen by grace. In other words, what Paul is trying to say dito is not so much yung parang si Lord na pinipili niya kung sino yung maliligtas at hindi maliligtas. What he's saying is that it does not depend on parang yung privilege mo o parang ikaw ay, you know, karapat-dapat lang to be people of God kasi mabait ka or something like that. Sabi niya, no, it's by God's purpose, no? And God's purpose is revealed, of course, through the gospel that all those who hear the gospel and believe shall be saved. So in other words, what Paul is saying, hindi niya sinasabi dito na parang, okay, wala na kinalaman yung faith, na basta pinili ka lang ni Lord. No, he's trying to explain na hindi na ang salvation ni Lord is by grace. Hindi dahil parang mabait ka kasi, no? Now, this is so true even now, ngayon. Kasi maraming tao ngayon, if we are going to apply it sa ano natin, sa mundo natin, maraming tao ang nag-aakala na, well, you know, basta gagawa ka lang naman ng mabuti, sumunod ka lang kay Lord, huwag kang gagawa ng masama, you know, then you are automatically part of God's people. In fact, meron ngang doctrine ngayon, yung tinatawag na anonymous Christian, which is basically the belief na mayroong mga tao na who are not necessarily Christian, pero dahil mabait sila, then it follows Christian na rin sila, no? Even though they don't actually profess to believe in Jesus. So yung idea ng anonymous Christian, okay? That's something na parang pinaniniwalaan ng maraming tao ngayon. And even if you don't know that, yung anonymous Christian, maraming tao nag-assume na, well, if I'm just a good person, if I just obey the Ten Commandments, no, basta wag lang ako mag-take advantage ng kapwa ko, then I'm all right. No? In fact, I remember there was one particular funeral service na kasi hindi ko kilala yung taong namatay, so I really barely talked about him. I just talked about the gospel. Pero may lumapit sa akin, kinausap ako ng isa sa mga kamag-anak, and then sabi niya, kasi siguro hindi ko nabanggit yung tungkol dun sa namatay, parang sabi niya, alam mo, si ganito, si ganyan, mabait yan eh. Kaya alam ko, nasa heaven siya eh. Kasi matulungin yan, mabait. You know? At marami siyang tinutulungan nung siya ay nabubuhay pa. Of course, I did not argue, pero just to illustrate na most people believe na all you have to do is just be a good person, no? And dahil doon, mapipilitan na si Lord to save you kasi you are a good person. Well, it's not like that, no? You do not become part of God's people dahil doon, wala kang special privilege. It is by God's purpose. And God's purpose is that through Christ, Jesus, our Savior, anyone can be saved, if they believe in the Lord Jesus, if they believe in the gospel. And God calls people to believe in the gospel. So here in this passage, Paul is not yet talking about all the different aspects, but he's saying na, basically, hindi porket ang mga magulang mo ay, Christian, automatically you are a Christian, you have to believe in the gospel. Also, hindi porket mabait ka, or parang ano ka, sabi nga ni Paul, nung pinili si Jacob, wala pa silang ginagawa, anything good or bad, It doesn't mean hindi importante kay Lord yun, If we read the story, of course, Jacob went through many significant transformations sa kanyang character, but he was a deceiver actually, Anyway, the point is, yung pagpili sa kanya ay hindi dahil mabait siya. Yun ang pinaka-point nun. So in other words, if we're going to summarize yung ating meditations today, God chooses those who will be part of His people, It's by God's choice, hindi something na parang pwede natin i-claim, hindi yung parang something na pwede tayong sabihin natin porque mabait tayo, It is by God's choice. Now, how God chooses, of course, is through the gospel. And by believing in the gospel, then we are going to be saved. That's the main point na sinasabi ni Paul. I hope today na clarify yan because there are a lot of misunderstanding sa puso ng maraming tao. That's why they remain outside of God's people. So, explain natin to, ipaliwanag natin mabuti if we can. And tayo rin mismo, make sure, lalo na sa mga anak natin, make sure that we explain the gospel clearly so that they too may be saved. At huwag natin i-assume na porket lumaki sila sa church, sila ay Christian na. Let's all pray. Lord God, maraming salamat sa iyo, Panginoon, sa iyong salita that clarifies and reveals to us the truth, Panginoon. Dear God, I pray, lalong-lalo sa mga parents na nakikinig, may we all have the courage, Panginoon, to talk to our children and to help them to come to faith in Jesus. And not to assume na porket lumaki sila sa Christian family, that they are already Christians. Or even, siguro kung mababait sila, it doesn't follow. I pray, Lord, that bawat isa sa amin ngayon dito sa devotional na ito would have the courage and the faith to make sure na yung mga taong malalapit sa amin truly come to faith in Jesus. Because that's the only way to be saved. Salamat po, Panginoon. In Jesus' name, amen and amen.